Hello, and welcome to the podcast. My name is Patrick, and I'll be your chief flight attendant today. We'll begin the show in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information. Three sheets to the mouse may contain language and subject matters that aren't suitable for smaller aviators, so listener discretion is advised. When the intro music begins, please take a seat and partake of any carry-on items. This includes bottles, flasks, cans, fine cigars, and skin mags. Okay, let's review. That is, F-bombs, earmuffs, get drunk, smoke them if you got them, and send nudes. Anything else? Oh yeah, enjoy the show. Fuck that little pig.
This is more shit.
Yeah, that's phenomenal.
Sounds sorted, but you'll be rewarded when at last I am given my dues. And injustice deliciously square.
That podcast is not that great.
This is Jeopardy! Now, entering the studio are today's contestants. First, he's a financial mogul with a penchant for basic witches, Adam Blisting. He's an angry Amish man whose love for sugarcane mojitos is so strong he just can't let it go, Trenton Nisbet. Our next contestant is a phenomenal lawyer with hair that Rapunzel has dreams about, Scott Farney. And our last contestant is an energy enthusiast and part-time DJ at the KNRG radio station, Tim Elbing. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Mikey Trebek.
Hello and welcome to Jeopardy, Three Sheets to the Mouse edition. I'm your host, Mikey Trebek, and let's see today's categories, shall we? We have Vroom, For Reals, Jungle Love, It's Good to Be Bad, Nothing But Semen, and Pretty, Pretty Princess. Trenton, you have control of the bird.
I'm going to go with For Reals for 100.
Okay, For Reals for 100. This individual gave the opening day speech at Disney World in 1971. Tim.
Who is Roy Disney?
Correct. Okay, Tim, you have control of the board.
All right, let's go with It's Good to Be Bad for 100.
Damn it.
Answer is? The official name for the villain most commonly referred to as the Evil Queen. Trenton.
It's Maleficent, right?
No.
Who is Maleficent? No?
No, I'm sorry. Scott.
Who is the Wicked Queen from Snow White?
Well, that's kind of what the question is saying there.
No, she has a name. So, I forgot her real name.
Oh, Tim or Adam?
I have no idea.
I forgot it.
Queen Grimhilda.
Yeah.
Oh!
I knew she had a real name, I just didn't remember what it was.
Yeah, Tim, I guess you still have control of the board. Where do you want to go?
Let's go Nothing But Semen for 100.
Nothing But Semen for 100. In Peter Pan, Captain Hook had a hook on this hand. Scott.
What is his left hand?
Correct. So now you're back at zero. What a dig. All right, and you get to pick the next category.
Well, let's go for some Jungle Love for 100.
Okay, Jungle Love it is. He's the head salesman for Magic Kingdom's Jungle Cruise. Tim?
Who is Trader Sam?
Incorrect. Who else wants to lose money? It's Chief Nami.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Trader really? Sam is Disneyland's head salesman.
I thought they changed them both.
Yeah, that's what I thought too.
Hang on, let's go to the judges.
Alex will accept Trader Sam.
Tim, with a $200 lead and control of the board.
Let's go with For Reals for 200.
For Reals for 200. Main Street USA is based on this real life city where the Disney brothers grew up. Scott.
What is Marceline, Missouri?
Correct.
That's it, you fucker.
He's from Missouri.
You wonderful haired heaven motherfucker. Dude,
this is the one everybody knew, but Adam's like, fuck! I finally pushed my button.
That's it.
And for naught. Scott, choose a category.
Speaking of wonderful hair, let's go Pretty Pretty Princess for 100.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay. It's the time the royal ball starts in Cinderella.
Starts?
Oh, ooh. God.
Tritton.
What is 8 o'clock?
Can you be more specific?
What is 8 p.m.?
Correct.
Oh.
That's what I was going to say.
I was going to say night.
I was going to say night.
Night.
What time did it start? Oh, it was fucking dark.
It was nighttime.
It was before midnight.
Okay. Tritton, you got control. What do you want?
Let's go with Pretty Pretty Princess for 200.
All right. The answer. This Disney princess was the first to be based on a real person. Scott.
Who is Pocahontas?
Correct.
Mikey, we'll stick with Pretty Pretty Princess for 300.
All right, 300. The answer. It's the number of Disney princesses that have evil stepmothers.
Oh, God.
Scott.
3, baby.
Yes, that's true.
Pretty Pretty Princess for 400.
Pretty Pretty Princess for 400. She's Pixar's first character to be included in the list of official Disney princesses. Tim.
Who is Merida?
Correct.
By the way, did you see the new trailer today that dropped for it? When they're all talking and nobody can understand what Merida's saying?
It's awesome.
And no. They're like, we can't understand what she's saying. And like, she's from the other studio.
Okay.
Let's close out Pretty Pretty Princesses for 500.
Okay. While not on any official lists, this Disney princess hails from the Kingdom of Atlantis.
Oh, I don't fucking remember her name.
Trenton.
Oh, shit. I was thinking the wrong thing. I was going to say, nope, I don't know. That's not... Yep. Take your points away.
Take your points away.
I thought Atlantis mermaid, and I was going to say Ariel. I got excited.
That was like Atlantia, I believe.
Wrong Atlantis. Yeah, well, technically, yeah.
No, Trenton, you're not the first to get excited at the cloaca.
Yeah.
I don't remember her name.
Anybody else want to try their hands at this one?
I have no idea her name.
Is it the bitch with the white hair? It's the lady with the white hair, right? Yeah, fuck. Mm-hmm.
That would have been... Her name is... Keita, Princess Keita.
Yeah. Oh.
I wanted to say Esmeralda, just for shits and giggles, but no, I wasn't bringing in for it.
Let's see here. Scott, you still got control of the board? Or no, Tim does. I'm sorry, Tim.
Let's pop the cherry on Vroom.
Vroom for 100. This is the number of stops on the Walt Disney World Railroad. Trenton?
4. 5. What is 4?
Yeah, I don't think we've been doing... We haven't even been doing questions on this. We've just been going... my research says no, Scott.
3.
My research said yes.
Yeah.
Main Street, Main Street, Fantasyland, and... Or Main Street, Storybook Circus, and Frontierland.
Yes. Yep.
Yeah.
It passes right through Adventureland. It used to have 4.
Oh, you're motherfucker. That's not even cool. Starting
December, it's going to have none.
Hang on. I don't know if I can go this far in reverse.
They're not running the railroad anymore in December?
They're shutting it down to do Tron work.
Yeah, they got
to
do some more of the construction on Tron. Okay.
Let's head back to the jungle for 200, Alex.
Scar from The Lion King gets his name because of a scar located over this eye. Scott.
What is the right eye?
Incorrect.
Oh, damn.
Trenton.
What is his left eye?
Hey, attaboy.
And I buzzed it too the first time, and I was going to get it right.
What is his brown eye?
What is his third eye?
Ooh. All seeing.
Come on. I was trying to like picture gorgeous. Scar's face on camera.
Yeah, I'm dyslexic, so right, left, it's all the same to me.
Adam knows that he does have eyes, though.
Yes.
I was Scar for Halloween 2 years ago, so.
Trenton, you have control.
Let's go with Jungle Love for 300.
Jungle Love for 300. The answer is she was the adopted mother of Tarzan.
Oh, fuck. Oh, I hate that fucking movie.
I never watched it. I don't think I've ever seen it.
I haven't seen it all the way through.
I didn't know she had a... I mean, I didn't know there was a name. I mean, I've
watched
it.
She's a gorilla.
In the mist.
Well, time's up.
Kala.
Yeah, no idea.
When they got that.
I would have never gotten that.
I'm kind of surprised. You guys just let all of Three Sheets Nation down, except for Kate.
I mean, I like Phil Collins. Does that count?
I love the soundtrack. So, Trenton, where you want to go?
Let's go with Jungle Love for 400.
All right.
As long as it's not a goddamn Tarzan question.
Actor Tim Allen narrates this Disney nature production featuring a young primate named Oscar. Adam.
It's the apes. What is the apes?
Wrong. Scott.
What is chimpanzee?
That's correct.
It was something monkey.
Apes technically and monkeys apes are the aren't same monkeys. Thing.
That's apist.
Oh well.
When I saw when I heard you read Tim Allen, I was gonna say Jungle to Jungle.
Oh my god.
Was that Disney?
Yes, that was.
Oh yes, man, I know what I'm dressing up as on the boat. All right, we're going to pause for a little bit of a break here and get to know our guests, our contestants. Starting with Tim, you've got comfortably in second place with 600 points. I see you nursing a bottle. What are you drinking, Tim?
Kona Hanalei. I haven't had it in a while, so I saw it today and I was like, meh, let's give it a go.
It's been a summer without Hanalei.
The last time I had it was at your house for your birthday.
Yeah. We haven't had too much Hanalei on the show this summer.
No, haven't.
We haven't had a lot of beer on the show at all lately. Yeah.
You know, I used to buy Kona a lot more often, but I feel like after they sold out, they have been not on sale as often and more expensive.
I still can't get it here.
They're about $9 a six-pack.
It's about the same. Here, anyway, it is. It's harder to find for some reason now.
It used to go on sale at the Harris Cedar Bar House for about $7.99 a six-pack. Like once every month at least, and now never.
The longboard lager can fluctuate around that price because it's good, but it's not the best Kona.
Mm-mm. The golden or the big wave is probably the best.
The big wave is the best, I think.
I like Golden Cliffs too.
The new pineapple one. Love that one.
Yeah,
I haven't seen that one.
It's new this summer.
I want to say
it started in like March.
It's a seasonal one though, I think.
Well, Hanalei was supposed to be seasonal too, but they kept that shit going all year long.
Mm-hmm.
Adam, you've been the quietest one.
Yeah, because I can't hit the buzzer fast enough. Game.
What are you drinking?
I have out of your Golden Chalice. Road Pineapple Cart. It's actually pretty decent. It's a wheat beer with pineapple, strawberry, and orange.
Wheat beer, that's going to be it's not so bitter because it's wheat, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so it's you get not more an IPA. You get more of the fruit notes mm-hmm. in that, I'm guessing.
Yes, very much.
Does beer have notes or does it have flavors?
Yeah, sure.
They have notes.
Yes.
I mean, obviously,
it all smells the same.
Like my favorite note from beer is the brown note.
Oh, God.
Which is actually a really good beer if you can find it.
Yeah, I was about to say, there's a real beer called that.
Yeah, yes, and it's I really enjoy it. I really enjoy it. Trent, you happen to be tied with Adam at negative 300 points.
All right, Trent, where are you?
The worst part is I've gotten two questions right, and I still have negative 300. Adam's got one wrong and negative 300. How does this fucking work?
I feel like I've seen this in a Disney attraction somewhere. Someone's negative points.
Yeah, probably going to go down in flames like that fucking attraction, too.
Just be careful, because
Modelo.
You know, the person winning is going to be Stupid Scott.
Stupid Judy, stupid energy.
Well, they do have the same haircut.
So. Very similar, yes. I agree with that.
I'm actually drinking Modelo tonight because it was on sale.
Is that the Modelo? Hey, my air conditioner guy drinks that too. Must be a thing.
It's cheap.
It's actually pretty good. I don't hate Modelo.
I don't think
it's
I've
a
ever
decent
had
pilsner.
It.
If you want a bready, you know, decent, you know, run of the mill pilsner, Modelo's the way to go. It's got that little bit of graham cracker sweetness from the pilsner.
It's like toasted cereal.
Yeah, it's a
cereal toaster.
It's good.
It's a good cheap beer.
It's good. I like it. I like their Negro? Modelo Negro?
Modelo Negro is good, yeah.
That's a great beer.
It's definitely better with a lime.
With all the Mexican beers, I'm going to use Mexican beers in air quotes. Yeah. Because at this point, they're really not.
Mm-hmm. There's not one that's made there.
I like the darker ones. Like Dos Equis Dark, Modelo Negro. No. They're a little bit better.
You would like Dos Equis.
Dos Equis is the one that I get. Like, if we go to the Mexican restaurants, I get the big Dos Equis.
Yeah. You know what? There's nothing better than a good Dos Equis with some, like, carne asadas tacos.
So, big spender there in the lead with 1,100 points, dollars, bragging right chips, whatever. Scott, what are you drinking?
So I'm drinking a bourbon. Actually, I'm not sure if it's a real bourbon or not because... Oh, no, it is. It is. It's a bourbon that's been making its way around the BSEA circles for being probably one of the most underrated ones, and that's the Woodford Double Oaked.
Is it really smoky?
No, it's actually really smooth because what they do is they put it in a charred oak cask first and then take it out of that and put it in another charred oak cask. And so it gets a lot more of those, like, charcoal filters out the whiskey and makes it smoother. The more char you have, the more smooth it is. So it actually gets a smoother, less peppery finish than most bourbons with the high rye.
But it doesn't have, like, a smoky flavor.
No. You would think that something called double oaked,
yes,
would have, like, a smoky flavor to it. It's no smoke whatsoever.
Because that's what I immediately assumed.
Same here. I thought the same thing. I'm not trying this, thanks.
It is sweet.
Bourbons usually don't have a smoky flavor.
Yeah. Very, very few American whiskeys have that peat flavor. No, this is really smooth. It is highly recommended. It's one of my favorite Woodford notes that they do. Woodford collections. I have a couple of them now.
Well, unlike on a typical episode when the host doesn't talk about himself or anything like that, I'll tell you what I'm drinking. I have a nice bottle of Misty Creek Syrah.
Ooh, I love that.
That is a damn good wine.
That is
that was my favorite of his was the
and
Syrah.
I'm refilling my Magical Meltdown.
It makes a good Chamberson
like
too.
A villain wine glass as we speak.
The Chamberson was a little sweet for me. I'm not a big sweet
wine.
Yeah,
that Chamberson was sweet. It's sweeter than the Chambersons I'm used to, but it was still good.
It was
very good.
It was very good.
It would make an awesome sangria.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
And that's
I don't like wine.
Or if since we're almost at the end of summer, a mulled wine.
Ooh. Yeah. That would be a good idea.
Because it's sweet enough that it can carry it off, and then you put the orange slices and the mulling spices, it'll taste really good.
That would taste really, really, really good.
Mulled wine. Then we can act like we're in Game of Thrones and sit around the fire and swing axes at each other.
One of us has got to die.
Yeah.
As long as there's titties somewhere, I'm happy.
Have you ever noticed the ones with the good hair always die?
Yeah. Jamie just lost a hand.
Well...
He also lost his hair.
Well, that was riveting information. We're back from our break. I'm glad we got to meet all of our contestants, and we're going to move on. Who the fuck was in charge last?
Scott.
Yeah, who'd have thought? Scott, what's next?
You know what? Let's do Vroom for 200.
Vroom 200. Before he became all rusted up, Tomater was this color. Fucking Scott.
Well, that...
what is teal?
God,
he's teal.
Teal is a blue-ish, and the color is a blue. You had to fucking say teal. You couldn't commit
just
to
say blue.
Blue
is it robin's blue. Egg blue? Because it's like
baby blue. It's baby
you
blue.
You say fucking blue.
What's wrong with blue? Blue?
What do we say?
All right,
we say that Scott has too many points. We're going to take it away.
Well, it's not like anybody else can fucking answer now, so...
Yeah.
He's Tiffany Blue. He's teal. It's.
He is not Tiffany Blue.
He's not Tiffany Blue. He's kind of like a light.
Have you ever heard that motherfucker talk? What do you think he would say his color was?
Blue.
I'm the same color as the sky.
It's
That's
not
what he would fucking say.
The same color as the sky.
Baby.
I'm the same color as Pabst Blue Ribbon.
I have about 40 tomaters upstairs with him in teal.
I just love the fact that you didn't say Ethan has 40 tomaters upstairs. You said you have 40 tomaters upstairs.
Because those are the ones Ethan doesn't get to play with them.
I might like that he likes cars. Whatever.
Do we take the points or we just let it slide? Nobody loses or gains. What do we do? I don't know. Teal counts. I don't care.
I thought teal was like a shade of blue-green.
That's what I mean. He couldn't commit to blue or green. He went teal.
Yeah.
I can go get...
That's like saying turquoise.
I was going to say turquoise, but... It's
cyan!
More,
of course you were, but you were like, oh, too many syllables. I got to hurry.
All right.
How about we just don't do any points on it?
Okay.
And move forward. Awesome. Damn it. Scott, learn your colors.
Couldn't
Whatever.
Just say
blue. Fucking course.
Pick a quest, pick an answer. Where are we going?
On the Pantone color scale, it's probably teal. Let's stick with Vroom then for 300.
Wally stows aboard this ship while trying to rescue his friend Eve.
Oh, fuck.
Hey, look, there's Scott.
What is the axis?
Incorrect.
Oh, damn it! I know it!
Adam. Oh.
The axis?
Close.
Axiom, however you say it?
Yes, that's correct.
That's
the
it.
Axiom
I
is
was
correct.
Close. I was this close.
No, you were that far away, I think, is what you meant to say.
Whatever.
You know, it's all teal. It's fine.
Yeah.
Adam, you have broke even.
Yay, I'm at zero.
You're at hang on, negative
You're at minus zero.
Okay, there we go. There we go. And
that's
you have
really
control the board. You
hey, pick... Scott goes down to 800 points.
That's
yep.
right.
That's, yep.
Thank you, Tritton.
Good luck.
Keep up with that
Good
for me,
out,
okay?
Trent.
Because... I got a lot going on over here. If you could see what
should be at 900, I should be at 900 points, but
1100 minus 800.
No, he's fighting his teal.
Oh,
he's fighting his teal.
I think you. No, because I really was going to say no on that. All right,
I'll prove you wrong,
Adam.
My God, sorry. We're gonna go. It's good to be bad for 200.
You guys realize you can pick any square, right? Not just the lowest number.
Yeah.
That's the wrong one. We're going to semen. Sorry.
Trebek's drunk.
The live-action film Treasure Island features the real-life persona of this popular pirate. No shit. No one's buzzed. Trenton!
Who was Blackbeard?
Wrong.
It was a guess. It's popular pirate. Who gives a fuck?
Glad you guessed it, because I was going to guess that.
Yeah, so was I.
Okay, well, that's probably going to be nobody then. It was Long John Silver.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I thought you were looking for the actor.
That is a fast food chain. This
they
is
make
bullshit.
Good hush puppies.
Oh, I thought you were looking for the actor, like that played him, and I don't remember it.
Yeah, it wouldn't have... No?
Was he a real-life pirate?
Yes.
No, but yes. Bobby Driscoll was...
Thank God I wasn't looking for his name.
The kid. I got a story about that. Post-war England. It's a post-war England story.
Of course it is. Because it has to do with the London.
Well
this biscuit-eating motherfucker.
No, so...
Tea and crumpets.
Post-war England, they had a law that any money that was made in the UK had to be kept in the UK and spent in the UK. So Walt would make movies in the UK like... Treasure Island, and they flew in Bobby Driscoll to do the
I just hope Bobby Driscoll's an answer now that you gave us all this little history lesson.
They flew in Bobby Driscoll, but Bobby Driscoll was American. He couldn't actually work in the UK, so they basically flew him in overnight, delayed the customs agent so that he could get in, work, do his like 3 days of scenes, and then flew him back out and said, oh yeah, fine, we'll full fly him out and he won't work here anymore. And then they didn't need him anymore.
The more I find out about Walt's business dealings, the more I think he's kind of a shady motherfucker.
Well, that was that day and age, man.
That's
that
it.
Day and age. Hey, yeah. Adam, where do you want to go now?
Sorry. Fuck it. It's good to be bad for 500.
I was going to say, I don't have anything called fuck it up there. Okay, here we go. It's going to be bad. 500. The answer is Robert Loggia provided the voice for Sykes, the villain in this 1988 animated feature. Scott.
What is the Black Cauldron?
Incorrect.
Oh, damn it.
I don't know who that is.
Me either.
You don't know who Robert Loggia is? You ever seen fucking Big?
No, I'm talking about Robert Sykes. Loggia is.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I don't know who Sykes is.
Wow.
You know how old I was in 1988?
Zero.
Not born?
-3.
What is, the answer is Oliver and Company.
Oh, I never seen this movie either.
I haven't
either.
Seen it like,
yeah, like
20 years.
30 never years ago.
To recap the score for everybody at home, Tim's at 600, Scott's at 300, Adam is at not, and Trenton's -500. But holding strong. Oh, man. Adam.
Let's go for reals for 400.
For reals for 400? Disney Springs' seafood restaurant, Paddlefish, was originally named this after Walt Disney's wife.
Oh, fuck. I was just listening to this shit the other day.
Scott.
What is the Lily Bell?
Incorrect. The restaurant was called the Empress Lily.
Ooh. The Lily Bell's the train. Shit.
Scott's at -100 now. Yeah.
Oh, I kept it to second
with 0 points.
Fucking A.
And you I just realized I just got to get sitting here and watch you guys get the wrong answers, and I win.
I had to adjust font sizes because I was afraid we were going to hit 5 digits.
Son of a bitch, man.
Nope. Okay.
Okay. All right.
Adam, where do you want someone not to answer again?
Let's go. It's good to be bad for 300.
All right. It's good to be bad for 300. The answer is, this is the devilish name given to Maleficent's raven in Sleeping Beauty. Adam.
Diavol. Or Diavol.
I got to say no. Tim. Oh, I'm sorry, no, Trenton.
I didn't buzz.
Oh, okay, then. Oh, he left. Okay, I'm sorry, Tim.
Who is Diablo?
Correct.
I thought it was Diavol. All right, oh.
In the new movie, he's Diavol.
My bad.
In the original movie, he's Diablo.
See, that's not fair.
How is it not fair? Because I said it's in Sleeping Beauty, not Maleficent.
Yeah, I know. I got excited. I thought I knew something.
Adam's getting all gung-ho.
Tim, you have control of the board.
I'm getting sweaty.
Let's go.
Getting sweaty.
What a win.
It's like he's watching Cops.
Watching live PD.
Watching live PD waiting for your relatives to be on that motherfucker.
He's getting sweaty like he's nothing, Stephen Avery.
Nothing but semen for 300.
Nothing but semen.
That's my best category.
Wonder why.
That's what he uses in his hair.
It's the real-world inspiration for the facade of Disney World's Pirates of the Caribbean attraction.
Oh. Which park?
Disney World.
Disney World's.
Oh,
yeah.
Fuck.
So we had a whole fucking episode on it, kids. One of y'all motherfuckers did research.
I remember the answer.
Fuck.
And I probably couldn't pronounce it anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Castillo.
That's it.
I'm going to shoot myself when it comes up.
Yeah, because I think you're the one that said it, because you were there's a San Felipe del Moro in old San Juan.
I knew it was
That's why they called the Castillo del Moro.
Yep. Man, I just...
Motherfucker!
I thought that was a softball of a question, because I was like, oh shit, we just did this like, you know, 15 episodes back or something.
Apparently the ones that Mikey thinks are easy are the ones that we think are really hard.
Yep, this is Kate all over again for us, so...
Oh, God. Okay, well, Tim...
Let's go. Fuck it. Balls of the wall. Vroom for 500.
Vroom for 500.
Vroom
the
those balls.
The answer is... This American city is a setting for the Love Bug.
Oh, my God.
I know this. Fuck.
I haven't watched these movies since I was little.
We could have had questions like, what was the name of the mouse in fucking Cinderella or something?
There was more than one, so thanks.
Yeah.
What is San Francisco?
Oh, fuck, I should have guessed it. I knew it.
Like, you don't have to. You're myself. Like 900 points ahead.
I know, but I still wanted the extra 500.
Yeah, we still got a whole double Jeopardy to go, kids. I know. Tim, where do you want to go next here?
It's going to be bad 200.
Yeah, softball. Let's go small point.
Well, it's bothering me because it's the only one that's still lit up in that area, and it's my OCD is...
As a grown-ass man, Gaston is said to eat this for breakfast each day. Trenton.
What is 2 dozen eggs?
Wrong.
Fuck me.
Scott.
What is 5 dozen?
Correct.
That is just humanly impossible.
Well, yeah.
Well, like yes. 2 dozen is?
Just think about
I would
all
say
the cholesterol.
2 dozen is a bit of a stretch right? as well. When he was a child, he only ate 4 dozen. Mm-hmm. But yes. As a man, he eats 5 dozen.
I had to go through the song, and that's...
So, Scott, you have 100 points.
Yeah, I know. Let's do For Reals for 500.
For Reals for 500. They are Walt and Roy's other two brothers.
For Reals?
For Free Reel or for Play?
Who gives about those two fuckers?
Well, yeah, okay. So, those two fuckers go by Raymond and Herbert Arthur. Also known as just Ray and Art.
I thought he only had one more brother and a sister.
He has a sister, but they also have two other brothers.
Well, those two really shit the bed.
Yeah,
the slackers, they didn't do shit.
Well, I guess that question should have been Final Jeopardy. That would have been the fucking equalizer. as it is right now, we got two guys that aren't going to be in Final Jeopardy.
Yep. Yay.
Okay, Scott, where do you want to go next?
Let's do Vroom for 400.
Vroom for 400. They weren't Iceman or Goose, but Val Kilmer and Anthony Edwards voiced this pair of aircraft in Planes. Scott.
See that fucking movie.
What is Echo and Delta?
Incorrect.
Oh, damn it! I know it now.
Anybody else?
No, I didn't see this atrocity of a movie. Sorry.
I've seen it, but...
I couldn't tell you.
I've seen it, and it's Echo and Bravo.
Yes, correct. Still kind of wrong.
Yeah,
it
I know.
It is Echo and Bravo. So, Scott, this is going to hurt.
It is. As soon as I said Delta, I literally thought about the two planes that Ethan has, and the other one was Bravo.
Ethan has. Air quotes on that shit.
Yeah, he said yeah, Ethan this time because he knows
it's
not
He gets
cars.
It wrong, and all of a sudden Ethan has them.
Man, I knew that. I knew it.
Okay, for real, that was... Hang on, I got to do some deducting here.
Shut it.
Was that 400, I believe?
That was 400.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay.
Wait, is Scott and I tied now for a second?
Yeah, now Scott's tied with Adam. Whoop, wrong button. Hey, Tim, you'll win. Don't buzz in.
I'm not
You're the only one positive.
I'm watching these guys, enjoying watching these guys hang themselves.
Episode 78, where Mikey asks questions and then answers them himself.
Okay. Scott, where do you want to...
Mikey Trebek plays Jeopardy by himself.
Scott, how much rope do you want this time?
You know what? Give me the semen for 500.
All right. Semen for 500. This be the name of Blackbeard's ship in the fifth installment of the Pirates of the Caribbean franchise.
Oh, fuck.
I don't remember. It's the only one I've only watched once.
It's the real name of his ship, too.
It is.
Oh, fuck.
Time's up. It's the Queen Anne's Revenge. Yep.
Queen Anne's Revenge. I knew there was a third one in
Dude,
there.
Yeah.
I should have fucking known that. There used to be a restaurant in Charleston that was, like, the shape of the ship called the Queen Anne's Revenge.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
Maybe that's what they were going for. Class.
All right, Scott. God. Clear the board, man.
I need all the semen. So give me the rest of the semen.
Okay then, nothing but the semen for 400. The answer is today's first daily double.
He can't do it.
Well, he can wager
up to the amount.
What is the highest amount currently available on the board?
Even though he's negative.
Yes.
Yeah, you get the value of the question.
Okay.
Captain... Oh, how much do you want? Well, too late.
Well, 400. 400. Okay.
Captain Moreland was the sailor that saw him and his daughter captured by pirates in this Disney adventure film.
Yeah.
These questions are fucking hard as shit. Yeah. Jesus.
I feel like we're playing with Kate.
What is where did you get these fucking questions?
Jesus Christ, dude.
What's the answer? That was awesome.
I mean, I'm gonna know the film when you hit go to response, but Jesus, that was my guess, and I just couldn't. I looked back at the film, and I don't.
Swiss Family Robinson. They got their own fucking tree in the middle.
I don't remember pirates in that at all.
Yeah, because we go into that fucking stairs the attraction.
Well, you know what? Maybe it's high time we go back and watch some of these old films like Oliver and Company and Love Bug and Swiss Family Robinson.
I just have Treasure Island.
That's what this is about. This isn't wanting to see what you know. I want to know what you don't know, which Tim knows quite a bit. He knows Don't Push Buzz.
Speaking of Buzz,
I know. Don't hit my Buzz.
How to win at Jeopardy? Don't answer.
Exactly. Or the ones that I try to answer, everybody answered before I could buzz in.
Okay, Scott, nexties.
Fine. Good to be bad for 400.
Okay.
Let me make up some ground here.
I don't even want to put my hand on my buzzer.
Trent's not even coming back in the room. Dr. Facilier is the only character in The Princess and the Frog to refer to himself by that name. All other characters call him this. Oh, yes. Okay, Tim.
Who is the Shadow Man?
Yes, the answer is the Shadow Man. Good job, Tim.
I knew the answer. I'm just...
So Tim goes up to 1,300, which is the highest score of the evening.
Is it sad that Tim could bet all his money in Final Jeopardy at this point and still
and
win?
And still win.
If he gets it wrong.
And Scott is negative four digits.
Well, at this point, I'm the only one that can play Final Jeopardy. Let's go for reals for 300.
For reals for 300. Whew. Good luck, kids. The answer is they were Disney's first color comic strips.
Oh, fuck.
Comic strips?
Damn.
I have no clue.
I've got half the answer in my brain.
All right, then. Correct answer
Something
is
Follies.
They were the Silly Symphonies.
Yep.
I was going to say that, and I'm like, no, that doesn't make sense, because they were movies.
Adam, you'd have been out of the hole, brother.
I know, but...
I mean, you're already in second place, but you would have been...
Is Symphony spelled wrong?
Symphonies was S-Y. Yes, it is. It is entirely spelled wrong on purpose. Trenton, for figuring that out, you actually get some bonus points. Because I'm feeling a little bit like like Drew Carey right now.
You just want me to be ahead of Scott, admit it.
You get 0.3 points for that.
So there you go, Trenton. All right, I'm guessing Tim, you want some Jungle Love, don't you?
Yeah, some Jungle Love for 500 bucks.
All right, here we go. Hardest one of the game, guys, so far. This author wrote the book that Disney's The Jungle Book was based on. Tim?
Who is Rudyard Kipling?
Core fucking wrecked.
I only knew his last name. I just knew it was Kipling.
Damn it. That works, Adam.
Well, I didn't know if I was going to get away with it because I couldn't think of the first name.
Yeah.
His first name was Rudyard?
Rudyard, yeah.
Dude, if I had another kid, I would totally name them Rudyard. This concludes the first round of Jeopardy. Stay tuned.
Hopefully the questions in the next round are harder.
Yeah, typically they are. Double Jeopardy's coming up next. Tim is in the lead with 1,300. Adam's in second place with minus 300. And Trenton's in third place with negative 699.7 points. And Scott's got negative 700. Stay tuned to these messages from your local.
After these messages, we'll be right back.
Welcome back to Jeopardy. We have entered Double Jeopardy, where everybody is doing the same shit again.
except for more just, points.
Just more poorly.
Just more points, and some of the questions are much harder because the game
awesome
kind of ramps up a little bit. So let's look at the Double Jeopardy categories. Double Jeopardy categories are his and hers, yo mama, answers to, or questions to this category will have to do with mother figures in Disney.
Thanos snapped and she lost weight.
The Graveyard. Kingdom Heart.
Ooh. Oh, fuck.
Cut God. My film in two pieces.
Nice!
This is my last resort.
This is my last resort.
Sorry. I didn't know that was coming.
Neither did I. That was epic.
Brilliant, I built, Alex.
I
Brilliant.
Built the whole fucking game around those two categories, guys.
What can I make the Jeopardy game on Three Sheets about? Papa wrote. Exactly what I was thinking.
My sister-in-law would love this game. Right
well,
now.
We ended single Jeopardy with Tim.
The lowest goes first.
Oh, is that how it happens? Okay,
yeah.
Well, son
yeah,
of a bitch.
Lowest goes first.
Man, just Trenton, you got the question. Scott's going first. So I fuck you on that.
Thank God.
Scott.
All right, let's, you know what? Let's do Papa Roach. This is my last resort for 200.
All right, the answer is... If you want to walk from Pop Century to the Art of Animation, you can cross this bridge. Tim.
What is the Generation Gap Bridge?
Correct.
Fuck Tim.
I Tim, knew you're the not answer. Allowed to play. You're not allowed to play with us anymore.
Throw something.
Old people accrue more knowledge. It's not fair.
You have the board.
Let's go cut my film into pieces for 200.
Okay. Answer is, the Little Mermaid sequel, Return to the Sea, features this villain, the sister to Ursula.
Yeah, who the fuck saw that?
Fuck, I never saw that.
I've never seen it.
Scott, you know you saw this shit. Just to, you don't have. We're not going to be embarrassed if you answer.
I've seen the movie. I've seen it once. Yeah, wouldn't know that.
Who's Morgana?
Wouldn't know that.
I almost said Vanessa, and I knew that was wrong.
Vanessa was the girl she turned into.
Mm-hmm. By my estimation, a lot of these aren't going to get answered because no one has seen sequels, but all of these pertain to sequels to Disney movies, which...
Wait, did you include Planes 2?
You have the con.
I like Planes 2.
I like Planes
That's why I didn't pick it.
I like Planes 2 better than Planes 1.
Mm-hmm, same here. That's why there'll be no questions on it.
Yeah. Let's go, yo mama. For 200 points.
Yo mama. Yo mama so hairy her name could be Grizzly Adams. Scott.
Who is Queen Helen? Queen Helen. Helene. Helene. Queen Helene.
Who the fuck is that?
From Merida.
From Brave.
Incorrect.
I don't know where this is going at all.
Neither do I.
Is this the mother from Brother Bear? Does he have a mom?
Scott, it was the queen from Brave, but her name is Eleanor.
Eleanor.
If you'd have said the queen from Brave, I would have taken it, but you were pretty fucking solid on Helene.
Oh,
I thought her name was Helene.
What a kick in the nads.
Why? Whatever.
Okay, hang on. I got to do some math real quick.
It's almost more fun that we all fucking suck ass at this.
Yes.
Yeah, it's kind of fun.
We hold a Disney podcast and we don't know shit about Disney.
I know.
I don't think anyone that's listening to this knows any of this shit either.
No.
Okay, Tim.
I swear we do go to Disney World.
Let's go. This is my last resort for 400.
Okay. This Disney resort was used by the music group The Beach Boys in the video to their single Kokomo. Scott.
Grand Floridian.
I was actually really hoping somebody would go Grand Floridian on that. Or would go the Poly. Just because... But hey, it doesn't matter. Scott, you're less in the hole, Trenton.
Last resort for 600.
All right, then. Adam, Scott's coming for you. Ooh, you got the first Daily Double of the second half of the game. Does that make sense?
Yep. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, Scott, how much do you wish to wager?
Am I still negative?
Yep.
Yes.
600.
Okay, then. For 600 points and positivity, if you have the points, you can stay here. The first official DVC resort developed off Disney property.
Bullshit.
What is Disney's Vero Beach?
Correct.
He didn't buzz.
Yeah.
He doesn't have to. He has a daily double.
It's daily double.
I'm back in the positive? Am I back in the positive?
Yes,
the
you
positive.
Have 100 points.
Oh, thank God.
You have 100 points.
I get to play Final Jeopardy. I'm not answering another question. I'm not answering any more questions.
Well, then neither is Tim, and he wins.
Yeah, he doesn't have to answer any more questions or even Final Jeopardy, and he still wins.
Scott, drive us.
Since it's the only one that pertains to Disney World, let's go Last Resort for 800.
That's if you are in need of libations, you can find them at this resort's bar called the Gurgling Suitcase. I knew Scott would get this.
Old Key West.
Old Key West is correct.
I love that. I love that bar.
Question.
What is Disney's Old Key West?
Are we going to be sticklers about that? Because I don't think everybody's been doing questions.
No.
I have.
I love that bar. That bar has some great stuff on the walls.
That tells me that Tim knew the answer too, didn't you, Tim?
Yep.
Oh. This is one resort I've never been to, but I would love to stay there.
We've never been there either, but we want
to
try.
Go to the bar. Honestly, go to the bar. It's really cool.
I want to go to the restaurant. Lou Mangiello did a review of the restaurant the other day. Who? It would be 900.
Olivia's? I've never been to Olivia's.
Yeah, Olivia's. He did a lunch review of Olivia's, and it sounded really fucking good.
Okay.
Scott's getting a
little Tim,
too close.
Tim, you're going to have to answer a question now, dude.
I know.
Well, at least until we get off this topic and he buzzes in again. Scott, let me guess.
Yep.
This is my last resort for 100?
1,000, yeah.
1,000? I don't count well. Wilderness Lodge features this geyser, modeled after Old Faithful, erupting every hour on the hour.
Oh, fuck.
I don't remember the name of it.
I know, because we just talked about how we didn't know the name of it the other day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I thought, ooh, I'll throw this in, that way we'll know. Fire Rock Geyser.
Yeah, I would have never gotten that.
Yeah. So let's go His and Hers for 200.
His and Hers for 200. This is going to be pretty intense. Y'all get your fingers over the buzzer. In Lady and the Tramp, Tony refers to the tramp by this name.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, fingers Tony. Over the buzzer can do it.
Tony.
It's Italian. Oh, damn.
Giuseppe.
Oh, shit.
Buco.
I want to say Buco. Butch. Butchie. Yeah, yeah, that's right.
That's real Italian.
No, damn it.
I thought it was.
It's Italian for a short-haired woman.
Are you sure it's not Italian for Olive Garden in the Magic Kingdom?
No, Tony's is worse than
Olive Garden. Right? Way better.
Okay, Scott. Make a fool of yourself again.
How was that His and Hers? What was the His and Hers?
Lady and the Tramp?
Lady and the Tramp.
Oh. Talk about Tony and then Tramp. His and Hers 400. Stick with
all right, then.
Weird category.
His and Hers 400. According to Anna, this is the color of Prince Hans's eyes.
Come on, Trenton. This is your jam.
I mean, I know the actual color of his eyes.
So you've been staring in his eyes all night, haven't you?
Well, Trenton, what color are they?
He's got green eyes.
If you were going to guess, what color did she say they were?
Emerald, green,
dreamy.
That's not a fucking color.
That's what she says.
She's getting the third degree from Kristoff. What color are his eyes? She goes, oh, dreamy. You fucking guys.
This game is
Scott, clear the board.
His and hers, 600. Let's clear this category.
This is the event that Prince Eric is attending when Ariel first sees him.
Is it the Horse Cockery Festival? Because that's what this fucking game is.
Oh, Jesus.
My wife got this one right, guys.
I bet she did.
I don't know an event. There's just fireworks on a boat, man.
Yeah, that's... I don't know.
What is his birthday
party? Oh, that's right.
Because they give him the fucking statue for
that's
the gift.
That's right.
I just want to formally apologize to all of Three Sheets Nation on behalf of these four hosts.
Yeah, apologize for us. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey,
we didn't make the questions.
We did pretty well on the last resort.
People are going to be listening to this in their cars on the way to work, screaming at their radio right
for
now.
Some of them,
well, that's what we want. We want interaction.
For some of them, maybe, but for some others, probably not so much.
This is about as much fun as a sandpaper dildo for me.
Hey, speaking of sandpaper dildos, Scott, you're up.
Mikey, I will say, we did pretty damn well in the last resort. Yeah. You know what?
Disney's more than just a hotel room, Scott.
I'm a glutton for punishment. Let's go his and hers 800.
Can't believe you're doing this.
I want to get rid of it.
Oh, scared you all the double so far.
And you can wager up to 900 points.
Yeah. $1, Bob.
You're going to go 1 point. Okay.
This category is shit.
She is Donald's twin sister and the mom to Huey, Dewey,
answer
and
to
Louie.
This. Motherfucker.
Thank God I wagered a dollar.
Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and take a dollar off your total, Scott.
What is Queen Grimilda?
Adam, who is it?
It's Celine or something like that.
No, it's Della Duck.
Della.
Wait, but you have to be careful.
Celine is the spirit.
No. Oh, this... You have to be careful with that one, because they're doing a whole different thing on the new DuckTales.
Okay, yeah, fuck some new DuckTales.
Well, Celine is actually, yeah, Celine is Della Duck. She's, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
That's
you know what? Fact of the matter is, Scott's going the other way now. He's at 899 instead of 900.
Yeah, well.
Because.
$1, Bob. $1.
And control of the board.
You know what? Finish it off. Get rid of it.
Okay, the completionist. His and hers for 1,000.
His and hers 1,000.
Why do I put my hand over the buzzer?
I don't know.
Is everybody ready?
No.
Yes.
This can make or break the game right here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
1,000
yeah.
points goes a long way right now. Naveen is the only Disney prince to do this to a Disney princess on film. Trenton?
Kiss her?
Oh, no. Big no.
No. No, that's not true. No.
Sleeping Beauty, it was kind of a thing, and then...
Yeah. Oh, God. At this point, I just want to see how many points I can not have.
I don't have... I can't go any deeper, man. You have maxed me out.
Hey, fucker, I rang in.
Oh, I'm sorry. Adam.
Cursed her.
No. Prince Naveen didn't curse anyone.
By kissing her, she turned her into a frog.
Well, technically, Facilier did that.
No, Facilier turned turned Prince Naveen into a frog. The kiss backfired and turned her into a frog because it wasn't true love's kiss.
I think you're going too deep into this.
Oh, because some of these questions weren't that deep.
You know what? The buzzer went off before you chimed in.
So what's the answer?
He proposed to her.
Did he really?
Yes.
Yes.
Did Aladdin not propose?
Nope.
No, he didn't.
Now, technically, Aladdin may have proposed to her, and this was going to be one of the questions, when they were flying on the magic carpet and they flew over Greece, ancient Greece, and he threw an apple to her. In ancient Greece, if you threw an apple to a woman and she caught it, that was considered a proposal of marriage.
Oh. You know, the more you know.
But I figured that'd be too easy. Is Scott still running the board that no
I'm
one's
still
got an answer
board.
To?
All okay, right, Scott. You know what? Let's get dark. The graveyard for 200.
He's avoiding that Kingdom Hearts game.
I never played it.
It is the only Disney film featured in all 1,928 feet of the Great Movie Ride.
Nothing, because it doesn't exist anymore.
That's why it's called the graveyard. What is Mary Poppins?
Oh motherfucker! Shit!
Here's an extra bit of trivia for Trenton. Do you know why the ride is 1,928 feet long?
Because that was the year that Mickey Mouse came to be.
I think that was the year that the Grumman Theater was built.
It's both.
It might be.
I think the answer is both.
Okay, well...
Trenton's dead.
More whiskey. Thank God tomorrow's President's Day.
Tomorrow's President's Day?
Yep.
I gotta fucking work. I don't give a shit.
Tomorrow's not President's Day.
Tomorrow's not President's Day. That's episode two. That's episode two.
I'm just going to go ahead and throw this out there. Kingdom Heart has nothing to do with the game. It's about Disney parks that have Kingdom in the name.
Mikey, let's go Graveyard. Graveyard for 400.
Graveyard 400. Okay, motherfucker. This attraction opened with a scene featuring a chicken, a dog, and Jules Verne in a rocket ship. Scott.
What is Horizons?
Correct.
I haven't.
I don't remember Horizons.
I don't remember it that clearly.
2 years after I was born, I'm pretty sure. So
hang on, I got to add points to someone. I haven't done that in forever.
You sure you know how to do it?
Yeah. Tim, here he comes.
Scott's getting too close.
Tim, 16.
Get some wrong, Scott. Get some wrong.
Oh, don't worry, Tim.
Tim, you got to buzz in.
There's, all right, there's plenty of categories left.
Trenton, let's make this fun for us. Let's see how much we can go negative.
That's pretty much what I've been doing already.
Adam, he's way ahead of you, man.
I could beat this.
I'll just start answering everything.
He's literally one question ahead of him.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Let's do Graveyard for 600.
Graveyard for 600. This ship merchant was the original owner of Disney Springs' Pleasure Island before turning it over to his sons.
You've got to be fucking kidding me.
No, because Scott? I know the answer, and it's not going to come to me.
Who is Meriwether Pleasure?
Correct.
Fuck. I knew... Damn it. For some reason, I thought Meriwether was the wife.
I looked like three places to make sure Meriwether was a guide, because I had to say his.
Right. I take it back. Meriwether is the worst first name. Not that
Meriwether was a guy's first name, because that was...
Oh, that just happened, Tim.
Ooh, Tim.
That was Lewis's name. Meriwether Lewis and Clark.
Meriwether Lewis and Clark be a real name.
Isn't Meriwether the name of one of the fairy godmothers?
Yes.
Yes, probably.
It's also Meriwether Adam. Trust me, I know a lot more about Pleasure Island than I needed to at this point in my life.
It's always New Year's Eve there. Or it was.
It
that
is.
Used to be. That was the used first to thing to go, to I think.
You know what? You could get negligee from fucking Jessica Rabbit's joint, apparently.
Yes, you could.
But that goes back to Disneyland, because he used to get bras on Disneyland trips.
At the Wizard of Bras.
On Main Street. Mm-hmm.
The Wizard of Bras. Best,
okay,
best name
Scott.
For Let's stick with the Graveyard for 800.
Graveyard for 800. Everybody ready?
Sure.
Trenton, I got faith in you.
Sure.
These are Disney attractions that aren't there anymore.
That all closed before I was born. Cool, let's go.
Tad and Rico are the troublemakers in this forgotten Epcot attraction. Adam. Or did you not mean to?
No, I did. I'm going to... Oh. The El Rio de Tiempo, the Rivers of Time.
No.
It's worth the shot.
Cranium Command. I said forgot because it's
the
brain.
Motherfucker, I was going to say it, but I don't want to lose more goddamn points.
I don't care
Tad
anymore.
The bullies. The bullies, yeah.
I've never seen it.
All right, Mikey, Graveyard for 1,000. I like this. I actually like this category.
Bring out your dead.
Oh, wait, no. My buzz is gone again.
We'll take a drink. In 1988, a stop was added to the railroad at Mickey's Birthday Land, allowing guests to walk around this cartoon city. Tim.
What is Toontown?
Fuck you.
Wrong.
It's not no. I know. Fuck. Oh, well, I'm glad he answered.
Scott, you knew he was wrong.
I know he's wrong.
Right one.
Can I guess it now?
Anybody can buzz in when I say wrong.
I don't want to buzz in.
Fucking Duckburg from DuckTales.
No.
I don't think that's
right. I don't remember that.
I don't think that's right.
It is right.
Duckburg was... No. It was it was there.
God damn it, motherfuckers.
There's pictures of it on the internet, too.
Yep. No, he's right. Duckburg was at Disney World for a very brief period of time.
It wasn't there long, though.
I call foul.
It's there. There's photographic evidence.
Oh, he's right. He is 100% right there.
Oh, fuck.
And incidentally, it had some of the best meet and greets, because you had like all of those early 1990s ABC Disney
afternoon.
All those characters were in that area, man.
It always had the best meet and greets in that area.
Okay,
though.
Who am I sucking points from?
Oh, look how happy Scott is now because he's winning.
Oh, all right. Mikey, since you turned me on to Kingdom Heart, let's do Kingdom Heart. 200.
Don't say they were easy. I just said they had nothing to do with the game.
Let's see.
That's fine. I've never played the game.
I am damn near done all with this bottle of wine, boys.
I notice that we're avoiding the sequels.
We are.
Nobody okay, knows the King answer to those.
And you know what? Good on you for clearing the history, whoever did that.
I like the graveyard. That was my favorite category.
Kingdom Heart. Here we go. 200. Magic Kingdom's Liberty Tree is adorned with 13 of these, one for each original colony. Tim?
What is a lantern?
All right, Tim.
Okay. Let's go Kingdom Heart for 400.
Okay. You can get an out-of-this-world experience when you visit this valley, located on the fictional moon Pandora. Scott?
What is the Moora Valley?
Close enough, I'll take it.
I don't know how to pronounce it. Moara?
Yep. I was expecting that to stump somebody because everybody just calls it Pandora.
I've actually seen the movie. It's pretty good.
It's a decent
movie. You know what?
Movie.
Thank you.
It's horrible.
For acknowledging that.
It's Ernest Goes to Camp.
It's the best sequel to Ernest Goes to Camp you're going to find.
I didn't hate it.
There you
I
go.
I didn't hate it, but it's not good.
I worked in an Ernest Goes to Camp reference this episode if Scott doesn't cut it out.
I won't. I like Ewan McGregor. I think he did a good job in that.
All right, Scott, with your 2,099 points from negative 1,100.
No,
I'm negative 1,100.
Oh, yeah.
Let's stay at Kingdom Heart for 600.
Keeping it Kingdom. Everybody got their buzzer ready?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Nope. Okay. Be careful when exiting the Haunted Mansion, or you could be going home with these three hitchhiking ghosts. Tim.
Who is Phineas, Ezra, and Gus?
Correct!
Oh, man. I quiz Ethan on this every single night we read the Haunted Mansion book.
And I always get stuck with Ezra, and that's where my brain shuts down.
Ethan knows the answer to this.
We just lost Trent.
See, I always remember it as Phineas and Ferb, Ezra Bridger, and Gus Gus from Cinderella.
Why not Ezra Bridger?
When I finally know a fucking answer,
everybody's faster than I am. That's what I figured out too. So
it's all fucked. So
my thumb is literally like.
Well,
a
mine is too, but I'm afraid to buzz in too quick because then I get fucking chastised.
Have you been chastised yet?
Just once.
No, yeah.
The first one. I was the first one.
And we gave you the points.
Just hit your buzzer.
Tim, you're up.
I'm gonna hit something.
Let's keep it Kingdom Hearts for 800.
This fictional farm is the location of Goofy's Barnstormer.
Oh, no.
Cheers.
Scott's the only one that has ridden this ride.
So
Adam goes, fuck it,
shit.
I'm out.
It's all on you guys.
Oh, man. Something acres. Oh, man.
It's Goofy's
acres.
Wiseacre
yeah.
Farm.
Yeah,
fuck
guys,
the Barnstormer. They get
and
more difficult when you get into big numbers.
Fuck this game.
Actually,
you're not losing anymore, Trey.
I am.
Okay, Tim.
Let's close it out. Kingdom Hearts for 1,000.
Kingdom for 1,000.
Fucking Kingdom Hearts. Let's close
watch out for rapids and debris from illegal logging practices when you explore the white waters of this river.
Oh, son of a bitch. It's a t-shirt.
It's on a t-shirt that we fucking have, and I can't think of it.
It is.
It's and I'm never going to get it, so no.
Neither am I, and I'm not going to be...
Good on the four of you for not falling for... I was fucking hoping somebody would buzz in and say Cali whenever I made this question. I just knew someone would say, well, fucking it's Cali River.
I was waiting for you to get finished reading, and I thought you were going to say on this ride, and then I was going to buzz in with Cali River Rapids, but nope, that's not the name of the river.
The name of the river is the Chakarandi River.
Yeah,
and you're correct, Trenton. There is a shirt that has been sold one time. So if you want to go to Animal Kingdom and look like a villain, go to MagicalMeltdown.com, get the Chakaranda River Logging Company t-shirt. And no one will get
my beard on it, so we can all fucking hate this game together in solidarity.
I'm not going to lie. I am losing the worst right now, and I'm having fun. So
I love this game. I love this game.
I'm having fun.
We only have two topics left here.
All right, Tim, I think you're still up.
Let's go cut my film in two pieces.
Oh, boy.
For
400.
Just go 1,000.
This actor passed away 3 months after the release of Toy Story 2. He was replaced by close friend and comedian Blake Clark.
Oh, shit.
I know the character he played.
Scott.
I know the character, too.
Jim Varney.
Correct.
We had to have a Jim Varney reference.
You guys let me have two Ernest Goes to Camp references this week. Hell yeah. Tim's just Trenton's just angry.
Slinky dog.
Because you know what when I want to fucking buzz. Nope.
Because
when I want to buzz, fucking angry. Hair is always first. It's fucking horrible.
I'm really good with my fingers. Cut my film in two pieces for $600.
Oh, Jesus.
I need Bill Nye to come take me on a whirlwind adventure and teach me how to
Can I come too?
Cut my film in two pieces.
Stupid Scott, stupid energy.
$600. The answer is, like its predecessor, 102 Dalmatians features Cruella de Vil wearing a fur coat of these colors when her plans are foiled by the pups. Trenton.
This has to be a trick question.
Black and white?
Wrong.
I'm going to break my computer.
I have a guess, but I don't think it's right. I don't want to go negative more.
Okay, Adam, what's your guess?
White and red?
No, it's black and red. In both movies, she was wearing black and red.
You know what? Let's go over to the other side and let's go Yo Mama for $400.
Oh, good. Another question I won't know the answer to.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting, guys, because some of these were kind of abstract.
Oh, you think?
Who is?
Some of these were abstract, not the whole fucking game, just this category.
Yo Mama's so old, she farts dust.
The fuck?
Yeah, this doesn't even make sense.
I don't get it.
Dusty Crop Upper doesn't have a mom.
Think of, like, the oldest mother character in a cartoon. Anybody. I mean, if you want points, anybody.
Does it have to be a real mom, or just, like, a mother figure?
I said mother figures.
Yeah.
Okay, Tim buzzed in.
Who is Yzma?
Who is she a mother figure to? Trenton?
Who is Rapunzel's mother? Because she's old as fuck.
Correct. Hey, Trenton. Trenton, you get to drive now.
Let's go Yo Mama for $600, right? Why not? This would be great.
Yo Mama's so vain, she probably thinks this topic's about her. Scott!
Who is Queen Grimhilda, or the queen from Snow White? The evil queen.
Correct.
It just doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Because she's always looking in the mirror.
I got it now.
Yep.
I got it. But my buzzer wasn't fast enough.
Let's stick with Yo Mama for $800. I don't know why.
Yo Mama's so smothering, she keeps you in her pocket. Scott.
Who is Lady Tremaine?
No.
Oh, damn it.
Who is Kanga?
Oh.
Yeah, Kanga and Roo.
I was thinking of the scene where Lady Tremaine keeps the key in the pocket.
Scott got minus. Well, I Scott's thinking figuratively when she kept the key.
Oh,
Scott was going after.
I did not know you meant the kangaroo pocket. All right, Yo Mama for $1,000.
Yo Mama neck so crooked she looks like she was kicked by Frollo.
Wow.
Scott, did you buzz on that? Okay.
I don't get it.
I'm starting the timer.
I don't get it.
Oh, I don't want to say because you give the answer away.
She doesn't have a name, so is Quasimodo's mom.
I thought she had a name. I was going to say Quasimodo's mom, but she didn't have a name.
Well, you should have.
I thought she had a name.
I thought she had a name too. That's why I'm like, I don't know the answer.
I don't remember her in the film.
She wasn't.
She was in there for a little. She got kicked down by Frollo.
She drops him off.
It's also a terrible movie.
Oh fuck you!
Oh, that it's a dark movie.
It's dark and sad and fucked up.
I think it is so underrated. I love
that
Hunchback.
Movie. The music.
Well, yeah, you're right, Scott. It is underrated. Maybe PG-13 is where it should have been.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Hellfire. Some of the best music is in that movie. The Bells of Notre Dame, Hellfire.
Here's what I know about our troop of hosts here. We are some single Jeopardy sons of bitches, but you put us in double Jeopardy. No. Not unless you get a softball category about hotels.
Hotels and the graveyard. I did well in the graveyard. That brought me back into positive.
You mean the two categories that had fucking anything to do? Never mind.
Yep. All right. So $800 for cut into pieces.
In The Incredibles 2, this character fights a masked bandit that is caught pilfering through a trash can.
Scott.
Jack.
Correct.
All right, cut into pieces for 1,000. Let's finish this bad boy off.
Just as Lion King was based on Hamlet, Lion King 2, Simba's Pride, also includes elements of this Shakespearean play. Adam.
Macbeth?
Nope.
Worth a shot. Why not? There's Shakespeare was the first
Hold
one
on, how many points do I have?
And then Adam left
yeah, I'm
the
fine.
Game.
Oh no, my phone Scott. Shut off somehow.
King Lear. Nope. Okay, that's fine. I had points to give.
Tim!
Romeo and Juliet.
Fucking A it is.
Is it really?
Yes, it is.
No, we're not yet. Okay, you know what? Just to make things interesting, so everybody gets a chance to play. Okay, so with the recent adjustments, we have Tim at 2,400 points. Scott fell down to 2,099 points. Adam somehow has 1,000 points, and Triton's got 1,002 points. As we go into Final Jeopardy, and tonight's Final Jeopardy category is Old School. The category is Old School. Contestants, please send me your wagers. All right, the category is Old School. Are we ready for the answer for you guys to write out your questions? Walt Disney's 1929 animation Jungle Rhythm opens with Mickey Mouse on the back of an elephant and playing this musical instrument. Everybody sent in their answers, so let's start. You know, fuck it. Adam and Tim are tied for Adam and Trent are tied for 1,002. Let's go ahead and just go ahead and start with Trenton. And your answer was what was your answer, Trenton?
It was didgeridoo.
And let's see what your wager was. Trenton, you wagered $1,002. Ooh, that's no good. Trenton, that's going to bring you down to $0. That's incorrect.
The didgeridoo.
Adam, what was your answer, sir? Which one do you want to go with here?
The bongos.
The bongos. Ooh, that's incorrect. Yeah, and what was your wager? $1,000. That's going to bring you down to third place.
For now.
For now.
So in third place, we have Scott. We'll go to him next. What was your answer, sir?
Mine was the ukulele.
Yes, it was. And how much did you wager?
I'd go big or go home, and so I'm going to say all of it. $2,099.
Ooh.
I don't care.
That hurts, because that ties you with Trenton. That's incorrect.
Don't give a shit.
Tim, you're currently in the lead with $2,400.
Yeah, I'm thinking I should just bet a dollar at this point. But I did bet all of it.
What was your answer?
A Doug Flutie. A flute.
Doug Flutie. They both blow. A flute?
Yes.
That's incorrect. And what was your wager?
All of it. So Adam wins. Who had $2?
That's incorrect. The correct answer is an accordion.
Why is he in Africa playing an accordion?
Why is he riding an elephant playing the accordion? Who cares? I win!
He's in Africa and he gets accosted by a lion on one side and a wolf on... Oh, no, it's a fucking grizzly
bear
on the other.
That's not geographically accurate.
It's you know what? It's an old black and white cartoon, and I figured instead of asking about the name of the cartoon, I would just ask what the musical instruments were, because everybody could guess. To close out this this week's episode of Three Sheets of Jeopardy, Three Sheets to the Mouse, we have Tim, Scott, and Trenton all tied for second place with $0. And I'm going to have to get my accountants to cut a $2 check to
Adam. But you know what, Mikey? You know what that means on Jeopardy? Trenton, Tim, and I get a trip to, like, the Maldives.
Okay, Johnny Gilbert, take us home.
Honestly, my cheeks hurt from laughing so much this episode. This was a lot of fun. I want to say, tonight on the cusp of breaking 1,000 members, we have had so much fun over the last year and a half with this show. It really is.
We got more members than the winner had points.
Yes, we did.
By a lot.
Shit, the Magical Meltdown has more likes than the winner had points.
Look, there isn't a dollar bill that's still in circulation that would pay Adam the amount of points that he had.
Oh, he's getting a $2 bill out of a stripper's ass.
No, $2 bills are still legal tender.
This was a lot of fun, Mikey. Thank you so much for putting this together. This was so much fun. I'm sure I speak for all the guys. We thoroughly enjoyed this. Well, I can't speak for Trent.
He tied you, motherfucker.
We will have more of these. We'll do this more often. But we will do this again. We will have some more game nights with the Three Sheets host. This was too much fun. Mikey, thank you for doing the questions. You know, you tied in the Magical Meltdown. We have some new t-shirts that you came out with last week. Awesome shirts, really.
You know, I got lazy or busy. I'm just going to say busy because that makes me sound like I was doing shit. And I didn't release two shirts I planned on releasing this past weekend, so my apologies for that. But I've got them, and they're in the queue. They're going to come out probably before this episode drops. I don't know. Maybe on Friday when people start getting paid, I'll throw my new shirts out there. And let me tell you, they may be a little risque. There could be some cleavage being shown on both of them. Both of them may tie in with a previous shirt release. If you want a set.
Yep, I'm in for that. Give me that pinup style.
They'll get you kicked out of the park.
Okay, so
that's what everyone wants.
Fine, so I'll wear it around the resort.
You won't get banned?
Make it a free shirt.
Mikey, some good stuff going over at the magicalmeltdown.com. Go check it out. Glassware, shirts, stickers, iPhone cases.
I'm drinking out of Magical Meltdown glassware right
now.
So
am I. All fun aside, we had a lot of fun tonight. Over at www.gktw.org, there's a wonderful fundraiser going on that we're trying to raise money for. That's Give Kids the World. This is Three Sheets meet up at the top of the world. We're going to have this awesome, awesome fundraiser going on where we have two prize packages. We've talked about it on Quickies. We've talked about it on the past shows. We've hit a new high for Three Sheets charity, really. So we have two awesome prize packages going on. What we want you to do is we want you to go over to www.gktw.org, Go over there, donate what you can, because this is literally led giving what you can back to Give Kids the World. Mikey, this is a wonderful charity for amazing people who are dealing with probably some stressful times in their life, and this is a way for them to feel a little bit of normalcy.
And by people, I think you mean like mostly mm-hmm. it's about the kids, but the families as a whole. And yeah, Give Kids the World, they welcome the kids down to their, I'm just going to call it a resort, because that's basically what it is. The kids go down there, they get a chance to forget they got cancer for a while, and that's where they stay. Now, they may go to Disney World, they may go to SeaWorld, and they may go to Universal Studios, but where they're staying is Give Kids the World, the little resort lodge area there, which every week they have one day where it's everybody's birthday, they have a day where it's Christmas for everybody, and it's, oh, hey, it's a great place to go. I think Stephanie and I, we're going to try to get a chance to go down there on our trip to Disney World in November to take a look at the grounds and see what they're all about, since we're both Make-A-Wish volunteers. Yeah, this is like, when you think of Make-A-Wish, I want to say it's like 70% that could be made up. I've been drinking a lot, but more than 50% of the kids, when they get a Make-A-Wish wish, it's to go to Disney World.
And this is a great way for us to help out the Give Kids the World charity. They're a nonprofit charity. They do a wonderful job bringing sick kids, bringing terminally ill kids down to Disney World for a week and enjoy a little bit of fun in their life. The fun we all have at Disney World, this is a great way for them to enjoy that. So we have two prize packages for our November giveaway. The first prize package is a tasting spot at the bourbon tasting experience at the Top of the World Lounge. This is a wonderful, wonderful event. Tim and Adam, you've been to this event. You've experienced it. You've had a good time there. You've met the bartenders. You've learned a little bit about bourbon, right?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Actually, I learned a lot because this was our first, like, true
foray.
Thank you, that word. Into bourbon as a whole. And Bree was extremely knowledgeable in any questions that you had, because I was new. We were both kind of new to bourbon at that time. Any questions that we had, she was totally knowledgeable about and, like, pointed us in the right directions, where to start and where to find some additional bourbons on property that you might not know about.
Little secret hidden gems that people don't know about.
Including herself. She went over to a special lounge that had some special bourbon.
Yes.
Yeah, and we're at a really good price.
At a really good price. But if you want to get in on this, this is prize package number one. So if you want to donate what you can, but it's $20 per entry. So if you donate $100 to Give Kids the World, screenshot your donation and send it to our Gmail. That's 3sheetsofthemouse@gmail.com. The number 3sheetsofthemouse@gmail.com will notate your entry into this prize package. Random entries will be drawn on October 1st, which is coincidentally Disney World's birthday. You'll be invited to the Top of the World Lounge with Mikey, Adam, Tim, and Trenton in November, along with some other special 3 Sheets guests. You will receive a 3 Sheets gift pack filled with some Glencairn glasses, some stickers, some other really awesome prizes that you will go home from your bourbon tasting, and you can go back to your house, taste some bourbons, and use these glasses, use these prizes to take your own little notes. The second prize package that we offer, if you're not going to be in Disney World in November, that's November 6th is the actual date of the bourbon tasting. If you're not going to be in Disney World on November 6th, 2018, you can enter into a really cool prize package, and that is prize package number two. You can still win an awesome 3 Sheets prize package that's glassware, stickers, barware, and maybe some personal touches from each of the 3 Sheets hosts. We're gonna add a little bit of personality to this prize package. You can go over there, get that. That is $10 per entry. So if you donate, let us know how much you donate, the same way you did the prize package number one. donate your share your screenshot from the donation page to 3sheetsofthemouse@gmail.com. It's $10 per entry, so if you have $100, you have 10 entries into this prize package. And again, the drawing will be on October 1st, 2018, which will be Disney World's, what is that, 47th anniversary?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, because the 50th is in 2021. Right?
That's right. So 47th anniversary. This will be an awesome prize package. Go over there, donate what you can. Again, we're not asking for a lot. Every little bit helps. We are at a pretty substantial amount, and we will announce the final amount as we get closer to the drawing. But I want to say I thank everyone at Three Sheets Nation. You guys have been amazing. The donations coming to children who have experienced unspeakable tragedy in their lives and have really had you're really making a difference in each and every one of their lives. So let's do what we can. Go over there to www.gktw.org, click the donate, click the help button, and that's where you can find your donation page. Whatever you give, great on you. We're going to give a little bit back to you in these awesome prize packages. This has been an awesome year and a half. We have passed 1,000 followers on our Facebook group. Go over to, if you're not a member of Three Sheets Nation on the Facebook group, facebook.com/groups/threesheets. We are officially over 1,000 sheeters. Go over there, check it out. It's an awesome time. Mikey, thank you so much for putting this together. Give us your closing remarks.
Oh, please go buy shirts. It helps me out. It's going to help us out a lot when we go to Disney World, because basically the teepublic funds just help me and the wife with our Disney plans. And you know, Disney ain't cheap. The shirts kind of are, and sometimes they pay for me to get a beer.
And the shipping is faster now.
Yes, the shipping is a lot faster.
Yeah, the shipping is very much faster now.
Someone says, and you know what? They smell as much like vinegar as they did before.
No, they don't.
Fair enough. I obviously haven't ordered any lately, because if I spend 6 hours on a design, last thing I want to fucking do is wear it to Walmart. So, yeah, I'm glad you all had fun. I hope everybody listening along at home 4 hours into this was screaming answers at their radio or through their headset. Or if you didn't, I hope you learned a little something. So the next time you go to Fridays, you can log in on whatever quiz app they got, and you might know something if it pops up for Disney. You can be like, oh shit, yeah, Maleficent's Raven was there, Diablo. Like that game from, you know, the 2000s.
Adam, give me some closing remarks tonight.
No, fuck, I'm not ready.
Okay.
Well, we have our meetups coming up. Cruises coming up. What? 50 some odd days?
52.
Under 2 months by the time this drops. We also are going to have a live show.
Yes.
August 20th. It won't be this game, but it will just be a live show. Come celebrate my birthday. It's actually on my birthday, so it's Monday. I also have a death treat, is what I'm calling it right now. Send me a Brett, set me a special gift.
Are you going to eat that on the show?
I am going to try to eat it on the show. But it's the devil's toe, or the devil's
toe. It is actually a toe?
Well, probably not actually a toe.
The toe of Satan is what it's actually called.
Oh, some bitch.
And
I'm so excited.
It's supposed to. All right, probably won't make it through this whole thing, but I'm going to try.
Oh, no. You're finishing that. You're finishing
you're crunching it. You're going to bite it.
Yes. Yeah, and then this is also going to probably be like the hot pickles that I ate that I actually really liked.
Those pickles are good.
No, we're going to see how many licks it takes to get to the center of the devil's toe.
Go, come hang out with us on August 20th. It's going to be an awesome celebration of Adam's birth. He's going to eat a hot toe. Devil's toe.
Devil's toe.
He's going to eat a very, very spicy delectable.
I can't help but think of Don't Be a Menace when he puts the hot sauce in that bitch's toe and he starts sucking on it.
Yeah.
Also, some important stuff regarding Star Wars races. Early sign-up is...
23rd.
Will be the 23rd for DVC pass holder and freaking rich people.
Golden Oaks.
Thank you. They will start, and the official sign-up is the 28th. There is a decent group of us who are running a lot of these, if not a majority of them.
Adam, when is the Star Wars race?
Well, here's the fun with this. If you don't want to travel to California, this is one of going to be the only ways you're going to be able to on the Kessel Run. Because the California races are suspended right now. Due to the Star Wars construction going on out there, they have actually suspended all the races out there. So if you want to get the Kessel Run without having to travel to California, this will be the only time to do it. They turned it into a virtual run for the first part. The actual Disney World part is the first weekend of April.
So if you're going to be in Disneyland, Disney World in this weekend, go sign up.
It's April 5th. I'm sorry. It's going to be the 5K is going to start Friday, April 5th, and the 10K will be Saturday, April 6th. The half will be Sunday, April 7th.
Okay, so April 5 through 7, those are going to be your chance to participate in the Star Wars marathons, the Star Wars runs. If you want to sign up, start when? August
23rd will be for special early access people. And that would be at noon. And then I want to say the regular signups go live Tuesday, August 28th.
Okay, so there's your dates on the signups for those run events. Those of you who are members of Three Sheets to the Finish Line, if you're a health junkie, if you want to join but go over to Three Sheets to the Finish Line. Search that in the Facebook bar. It's a lot of fun. We have hashtag Accountability August, and
which is amazing.
It is amazing. And Tim, what are we doing for September?
Blown up. Well, I was going to add something to September because we're doing... Well, we haven't really decided what the hashtag was going to be for September. We should put a vote, I think.
So, yeah. So, if you're a member of Three Sheets the Finish Line, make your suggestions.
And if you're not, and you like to run, come join us. The group itself has grown tremendously in the last 3 weeks. I mean, we talk about our regular group, the Three Sheets of the Mouse group, growing to 1,000, but we've... got like a 25% growth within the last 2 weeks with Three Sheets to Finish Line.
Absolutely. And look, it's a great group. Go over there, join it. Again, search in the Facebook search bar, Three Sheets to the Finish Line. That's where you're going to find that group. It's a wonderful group of people who are just dedicated to running when you can. If it's every day, great. If it's not every day, when you run, post it. We have some awesome runners. Everybody who posts on there, good on you.
Well, I just...
We can't all be Adam Hodge.
Well, but that's the point I want to make. We are not a bunch of hardcore runners.
We're not Kenyans.
By any stretch of the imagination.
We're not Kenyans.
We have people who are just starting out running, and we have people who've been running competitively for years.
Mm-hmm.
So, and you can find your groove here easily. I mean, whether you're doing your first 5K, whatever it is, we're here to help out. We all share ideas. We all share training methods and all that stuff. So definitely check it out.
And it doesn't need to be limited to running. If you're a road cyclist, if you do CrossFit.
It's dedicated to all fitness.
It's dedicated to
those.
If you
want to get healthy after drinking with us and Three Sheets to the Mouse, if you want to get healthy, come over to the other group.
Yep, you can mall walk with me.
So Adam, tonight as we close out, it's been a wonderful night.
I just want to raise what little left is my glass to my great uncle who passed this week. So thank you all for your kind thoughts and words. And I truly appreciate all guys, everybody who's reached out to me. I am really not good at Facebook. I'm really not good at social media. So I apologize if we didn't get a personal response, but... it really meant the world to me that you all cared. So thank you again. Thank you for your thoughts. And mazel tov. I'm going to cry, so cheers. I need to stop talking.
Cheers, Adam.
To Uncle Stanley.
So, Trent.
No, I just want to encourage everyone to go over and give us a rate. That's the best way, a rate or review on iTunes or Podbean or Stitcher, wherever you listen to us. That really helps other people find the podcast. Share it with your friends. That's what we want. We want more friends. We want more Ohana. We want more, you know, we want more people to hear us. I want to give a big shout out to Rick Reagan, too. Rick Reagan recently sent me a care package with some sweet Stanley Cup final winner Washington Capitals gear. Super stoked on it. And some cigars, so thank you, Rick Reagan. Super stoked to meet everybody in November. I'm not going on the cruise because no one donated money to that.
That GoFundMe went nowhere.
Trends, cruise dreams die every day.
No, but it's good that I'm going to get to meet people in November. I'm excited how many people are coming. It's kind of surreal of how many people that are going to be there in November. Every time I look at the list, I'm like, holy shit. People are going to want to meet me and stuff. And, like, I don't know if I can live up to the hype. So,
I don't think there's any hype.
I'm not going to be as angry in person because I'm going to be in Disney. People will be like, I thought this guy was mad all the time. And I'm like, I'm really not.
So, you know what? Before we meet everybody, I'll just punch you in the faces when you get really angry. And you can live up to the hype.
I don't know if that made me angry, though.
Well,
I'm
no.
Hurt.
Apparently, all you have to do is make Trenton lose at a game, and then he gets angry.
Oh, it's not losing at a game. Bring up the fucking sugar cane mojito, and I'll fucking be pissed off. There you go.
So, Tim, we have come to the conclusion of our first game show of Three Sheets Nation.
So we talked about our running group. We have a couple of September quotes that we're kicking around. We're going to put up a poll and see what you guys think is best. But I also wanted to say, you know, we a bunch of us are doing the race in November, and training's going to start to get pretty
heavy,
hectic, and pretty heavy. So I'm going to do sober September.
What?
We did a dry March. I'm doing sober September.
You're the only one in that household doing that.
I am. And it's going to be a very boring couple episodes for me. So if you want to tune me out for the month of September, that's fine. But I would have to do it.
I am not doing sober September, just so y'all know.
I'm going to Disney in September. I can't do it.
Then
I will do...
That's fine. You don't have to. I'm just doing it for myself. And if any listeners or any finish liners want to join me, they're welcome to.
I probably will not be doing sober September.
I will join you in giving up one of my favorite things, and that's no tortilla September.
You're not doing that shit now. Fuck you. That's not like some...
Yeah, because you're on a keto.
Some solidarity asshole. I'm going to give up something I've already gave up 40 fucking days ago.
I will do... No drinking except on the weekends.
That's what I've been doing, actually.
I could do that.
I have not.
I could do that.
And then, only then, it's two drinks. Two drinks September for me.
I will say, Mikey, I want to thank you for doing the show. This has been a lot of fun.
You have said that.
I said it a lot because I had a lot of fun tonight, even though I didn't win.
I'm going to smash my own brain in.
I won. No.
Adam won with $2.
Shocking his whole fucking half.
With $2, Adam won. So... From all of us here at Three Sheets of Mouse, thank you for making our show a part of your Disney life. Thank you for your time this time. And until next time, so long for just a while.
You're welcome. And thank you.
I left us a review. Fucking 5 stars, man.
Good night, guys. Love y'all.